Yo, how's it going, guys? Adamex here, hope you're all doing well, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to completely stop Windows updates from running in the background and why you would want to do that. So most of you might already know this, but Windows updates revert optimization, tweaks, and settings, and can even give you bloatware and pre-installed apps, which can all reduce performance and ruin your system latency. Not only that, but Windows updates actually causes most of the bugs you can get on your system, like a black screen on boot because of a corrupted display driver installed by Windows update, outdated network drivers, which causes packet loss, and many more other bugs. And also, some of you might be wondering if it's even safe to disable Windows update. And yes, it is safe. You should actually never need to update Windows unless there is a specific app or driver that is becoming unsupported or is just missing some feature. And in that case, I will also show you how you can enable updates back if you need them. And lastly, you can only do this method if you have Windows 10 Pro, Windows 10 Enterprise, or Windows 10 Education. You can check if you have any of these by clicking your Windows key and R at the same time, then type in WinVir, click Enter, then it's gonna show you the current Windows version you are on right now. So for me, it says Windows 10 Pro operating system, which means I can do this method because I am on Windows 10 Pro. If you have Windows 10 Home, then to do this method, you would actually need to get Windows 10 Pro. And to do that, you can either buy a cheap key from anywhere online. There's a ton of websites that sell them for cheap, or you can do the free method, which I am not going to mention in this video since it's illegal and against DTOS, but you can just search it up if you would like to. So with that being said, guys, let's get into the video. So the method I'm about to show you is the easiest way you can do this. I've worked on it for a couple of days and made sure that it works on all systems. You simply just want to download the folder. I will leave the link for it down below in the description. After you download it, you just need to extract it with 7-zip or WinRAR. And after you do that, simply just double click on it. And in here, you're going to see a couple of files. You want to start by disabling UAC. It's basically required to run this rec file because this will fix the batch file from just giving it a quick flash and not working. You just want to double click on it, click yes and then OK, and then restart your PC and come back here. So now that you restarted your PC after applying the disable UAC file, now you want to double click on disable Windows updates batch file. Double click on it. It's gonna first stop the Windows update and update orchestrator services, and then it's gonna add the registry dewars to disable Windows updates. So after it's done, you simply just wanna click enter or any key, and now you wanna double click on Windows update settings. And now you will notice that you cannot check for updates anymore, and if you click on view configured update policies, you're gonna see that automatic updates are disabled. So after you've checked that, you can now exit out of settings, and now you wanna right click on power on, click properties. Most of you will probably have an option right here that says unblock. Just check it, click apply and OK. And then you want to drag for disable Windows update services, drag it over to power on, lift your finger, click yes and then OK. If you use Microsoft Store or apps installed from it, then you will most likely need to enable the Windows update services with the registry file in the revert folder and run it with power on the same way you did it with the disable registry file. That's fine though, Windows updates are still disabled even if the services are started. We just disable them to reduce the amount of services running. So that was it for the video, guys. I hope you all enjoyed it. Make sure to like and subscribe if this video helped you. Stay safe and I'll see you all in the next one.